Now, I want you all to meet Officer Bridges. He's on staff as of today. I won't introduce you individually, as I'm sure you'll soon become familiar enough.
Oh, Mrs. Pearl!
Well, it seems like a pretty good atmosphere in here, am I right?
Oh, yes, I feel wonderful at the moment. Thank you very much.
Well, it's certainly refreshing, being among all these women after being in a male prison.
A job can be just as hard, though.
Oh, I'm sure it can be at times. But I'm more comfortable around women. I suppose it's because when I was growing up, there was just Mum and myself. We were pretty close. Mm. Yeah. That's her.
Oh, she looks nice.
Yeah.
So, how long do you think you'll be staying here?
Well, I'd like to make a few changes if I can. I feel by locking these women up, we're defeating a purpose. We have to make an outlet for them, make them feel worthwhile. Of course, I hardly started yet. I'm still finding my way around, but well, I intend to.
Can't keep a good bloke down, eh?
You've got it. Cheers.
Who are you?
New officer.
I didn't think you'd come to fix the TV.
David Bridges. And you're?
Mary Adler.
You're right.
What's it to you?
You look a bit of colour.
Well, so would you be if you'd just been laid out by a bloody great ox.
Is there anything I can do?
Ah, no, she's right. But thanks, anyway.
Who's winning?
Oh, the other bloke.
Hello, love.
Good. Horrid, it was worth getting back just to be sitting here with a handsome young fella.
You ladies don't have it too bad, do you?
Oh, jeez, Mr. Bridges, I don't know. Miss Ferguson just sat us out playing netball in the rain. That wasn't much fun.
That was volleyball, Cass.
Well, whatever, wasn't much fun.
Seriously, though, is it really so awful in here?
Well, it's no picnic, dear. Might be a piece of cake for you lot. You just put in your hours and then you're off home. But we're stuck in this bloody lousy joint forever.
Yeah, you tell him, Lizzie.
Look at this poor little bugger here. You'd give your right arm to be somewhere else, wouldn't you, love?
You bet.
I'm getting out soon, so it's all right for me. But young Mary here, she's got years to do yet.
It's hard when you can't see the light at the end of the tunnel.
Yes, I can see how it would get you down. Well, we'll just have to think of ways of solving the problem, won't we? Chin up, Mary. You concentrate on getting better, okay?
Yeah, sure.
All right. I'll see you ladies later.
Where's Mary? She's meant to be in here with us, isn't she?
She is. I heard Po-Face call her name after Muster. Bloody wonderful. 2 days out of hospital and they send her back to work. Certainly want their pound of flesh.
Yes, dear. Someone must have seen her. She's got to be around somewhere.
Well, she was talking to Mr. Bridges after Muster, but that was ages ago.
You know, I'm really happy for you, Lizzie. I don't like the thought of you cooped up in here.
My Arthur's got a really soft heart. Bet you look after your mum too.
Yeah, we were pretty close. Would you like to see a photo?
Oh, yeah.
Here we are.
Oh, she's lovely.
She was a saint, Lizzie.
Got any thoughts on these escapes?
No, not one. I've seen escapes before. And even when they weren't caught, we usually knew how they got out, but this time there's not a trace.
Yeah, there's a good brain behind this one. There aren't too many of them in this place.
Any ideas?
Yeah, it'd have to be Donovan. She's the only one who could mastermind something this big.
But if only one woman's behind it, she'd have to have the help of all the others.
That's Donovan.
Well, well, well. What a pleasant surprise. Business or pleasure?
I was wondering if I could have a word with you.
Fire away.
Are you still interested in going free?
Yes.
Good. Then I'm in a position to help you.
I see. And while you're helping me, you thought you'd make some money for yourself on the side, is that it?
No. I don't work like that, Stevens.
Then what do you want?
You know, one of the main problems with prison life is that everybody becomes so suspicious.
And what's in it for you?
Nothing. It's enough that I see you free from here. It doesn't achieve a thing putting you behind bars.
So how are we going to plan this escape?
You just leave all the details to me. The important thing right now is to get you out of here as soon as possible.
I'll go along with that.
Good. Well, I'm off duty tomorrow morning, so it'll have to be tomorrow afternoon.
Well, well, Mr. Bridges.
And where are you off to, Randy?
Oh, the laundry. Did you have to remind me?
Yeah, I agree. It's a pretty depressing place.
The whole of Wentworth is depressing.
You're right. A guy like you shouldn't even be in here.
My sentiments exactly, but the magistrate didn't agree.
That's the trouble with this world. Very few people have any real understanding.
I've heard that you can be very understanding.
Really? What else have you heard?
The word is you've been helping people to escape.
And I thought that was a secret.
I mean, it's true.
We don't want everybody here, do we?
Oh, God, you're amazing.
Just sympathetic. Actually, I was waiting here for Stephen, and she was to be the next one.
Sonia?
Mm-hmm. She's running very late, though. Would you like to take her place?
You mean you'd help me to get out?
Sure. But you'll have to decide now.
Oh, hell, why not? A girl needs a little excitement in her life.
She does indeed. Come on.
Where are we going?
To the boiler room.
Is there a tunnel?
Just think of it as a magic carpet. Off you go.
Actually, there was something I wanted to talk to you about. Do you mind?
All right, what is it?
When you realised I was unable to make the appointment, you saw Ferguson had me bailed up.
Yes, I'm sorry about that, Sonia, but that little mishap cost you your chance.
But it wasn't my fault.
Perhaps, but everything was arranged. I had to let someone else go.
You will get me out of here, won't you?
It's possible.
When?
This whole thing's very dangerous, Stevens. Look, I've got to go.
Wait. How will you work it?
You must be more patient, more discreet. If they find out what I'm doing, you'll never get a chance. I'll be in touch.
It's good, love.
I've no idea. She could be rusted next.
It's typical of the way this place is run. Keep it up. You'll fit in very well.
These searches, they're always so damn futile. Right. Nothing. Okay, boiler room next. Let's get on with it.
Look, would you like me to do that? You could check on Mrs. O'Shea and Miss Radcliffe if you like.
Oh, well, you've won me. Thanks.
Morning, Meg. Oh. Anyone notice I'm late?
No, not. Joan's busy elsewhere.
I practically ran the gauntlet out at reception. Mrs. Barry said she'll smack my bottom if I do it again. She's a funny stick, isn't she?
Ah, you have to watch these motherly types.
What's this? Something I'm too young to see?
No, I just didn't want to upset you.
What are you talking about?
I found out about your mother.
Sorry?
Well, her murder. It's all in there with all those other poor women. Sorry, David. Must have been awful for you.
You're not making any sense, mate. Yeah, well, she does look a bit like my mother, but she died 15 years ago.
But you said you'd help me.
And I will, I promise. But Minnie's a bit upset about some of the women that I'm letting free, so I have to deal with her first.
Why can't she wait?
Don't worry. It'll happen. First I release Minnie, and then you. Donovan?
Oh, yes, Mr. Bridges.
Oh, I'll see you later, Miss. All right, dear.
I've been thinking about what you said, Minnie. Come along with me.
Then you'll stop these escapes, or I am glad.
Well, it's not as simple as that, Minnie, because I'm committed to it, you see. But what I was thinking was, if I set you free, then you'd realise that the others were never coming back.
But I don't want to escape. I'll get out. Don't you fret yourself. But I'll do it through the court, nice and legal.
Well, at least let me show you how I release the others. Then you won't worry anymore. Will you come?
Of course I will, dear. Where are we going?
To the boiler room.
The boiler room? How on earth do you get rid of them through the boiler room?
Must be patient, Minnie. Sooner or later, you're going to know all my tricks. Just trust me, okay?
All right, Mr. All right. Bridges. I can't wait to see how you do it.
Well, here we are, Minnie. You will understand, won't you?
Of course I will. I think it's very brave of you. Someone's coming.
Something wrong, Mr. Bridges?
No.
It was my fault, Miss Ferguson. I thought I heard a noise.
Really? Well, then perhaps we'd better have a look.
Oh, there's no need. I checked already. Nothing. Joyce Barry did say something about rats in the area, though.
Rats? Oh, horrible creatures. Let's get away from here.
Well, Donovan, we'll take you back to the recreation room.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Quite a character, isn't she?
If you like criminals... Now, I've got to collect a few of the women for transfer. I could do with some help.
Yes, of course.
Ah! Rotten thing!
Now, you stay here, okay?
Oh, yeah, righto, Mr. Bridges.
Good.
Oh!
What's the matter, Lizzie? Oh. What's the matter? Shh, what's the matter?
Oh, the body. Body, Mr. Bridges. Oh.
Wrong, oh. Lizzie. Shh. There are two bodies. I set them free. You can be free too. See?
Lizzie!
Oh, Jesus.
I think she's had a heart attack, Cass. You better go and get help.
Oh, right.
Quickly, Parker.
Yeah.
Well, Lizzie. You're free now. I set them free. And now. You can be free too. See?
Lizzie!
Oh, Jesus.
I think she's had a heart attack, Cass. You better go and get help.
Oh, right.
Quickly, Parker.
Yeah.
Well, Lizzie. You're free now.